The following terms, three terms that I'm going to mention, you will not find them in a general anatomy textbook, but you only find them in anatomy textbooks that are dedicated for dentistry students. Actually, they are used in clinical practice. And one of these terms is called the internal oblique line. And this is the ridge of bone on the internal surface of the ramus of the mandible. And you can see, I can follow it here. It starts here from the lower part of the coronoid process. So it is oblique and it is located on the inside of the mandible. So it is called internal oblique line. Remember, we have an external oblique line here, which comes from the mental condyles upwards until the anterior part of the ramus. So this is the external oblique line. And this one is the internal oblique line coming down from the coronoid process. And we have this concavity here. This concavity is not labeled in anatomy texts, but for dentistry, it is called the coronoid notch. This sharp concavity of the ramus of the anterior border of the ramus of the mandible. So don't confuse it with the, another notch, which is the mandibular notch here. This is called the coronoid notch. And then between this coronoid notch, between the internal oblique line, you can see here that there is a triangular fossa behind the third molar. It is called the retromolar fossa. Retromolar fossa, because it is behind the third molar tooth.